Well, I think, you know, I think scenario planning is simply a way of fully imagining options. So there's a lot of misunderstanding about scenario planning. One is that it's about coming up with different views of the future and then choosing one. That is absolutely
that's what I'm complaining about, I guess.
And that's not what it's about. It's really about coming up with a number of different scenarios of the future and then interrogating each one and saying, okay, if scenario one were to come true, what would I wish I had been doing right now in order to put myself in a stronger position for that eventuality? And similarly with, you know, scenario two, three, and four. And so what it really is at its best at is surfacing choices, options, and alternatives. And I think actually it is quite possible to live with this. I remember, probably 2010 to 2012, having a number of arguments with my husband about when the next banking crash would be. And it suddenly struck me this was just a stupid argument, right? Because neither of us knew, you know, no little economic fairy had sprinkled gold dust on us. And I said, okay, let's ask a different question. Let's ask the question, if there is another banking crash, or when there is another banking crash, what will we wish we had been doing right now? And we thought through that in some pretty gritty detail about where we would want our investments to be, where we would want to be, what resources we would want to have. And so we slightly changed some of the things we were doing. We accelerated some things. We put other things on hold. And what it did is it left us feeling, okay, we don't know what the future is, but we think we've placed ourselves in a reasonably robust context. And actually, that's pretty much all we can do. So we can stop having this stupid argument for a start and get on and enjoy our lives, you know, feeling that to the degree that it's possible, we've done the responsible things.